So recently I met this guy, Jonathan. He's an American, but he actually grew up in China. And so he speaks like, 你可以给我们自我介绍一下吗？
对，可以，我做一个简单的自我介绍。大家好，我叫陈德忠，我今年24岁，父母都是美国的，但是爸爸妈都是美国的。但是我从小从3岁的时候，我父母的工作搬到四川，他们在四川当外教，在西南财经大学当外教，所以我从3岁的时候到18岁，高中毕业以后就搬回到美国。
Wow，所以你基本上18岁之前都是在中国长大的，
都
都
是
在
在中
四
国，都是
川。
在四川，对，都在成都，对，所以
哇
我觉得我普通话还可以，还可以，但是我四川话更标准，但是
对，是不
我
是你的
去
四
年
川话比你的普通话还好？
还好，肯定还好，对，
哇。
我去年在北京工作。当一个翻译，所以我天天都在讲普通话，必须要是很标准的普通话，所以我经常发现我的那个口音都是有一点种四川的感，四川的声音，四川的感觉，所以
你
我在北京的时候必须要自己四川话不能说，但是我回到四川，回到成都的时候都是讲四川话，我们在家里面都是讲四川话，跟我哥哥，我们是三兄弟，我是老幺，最矮的老幺。
你可以给我们演示一下四川话怎么样吗？
可以啊，可以啊，可以，我随便说四川话都可以啊。我从小在四川那边长大的，然后在那个小学开始，我5、6岁就开始讲四川话，但是在成都那边上课的时候，老师都是讲普通话，但是你下课以后跟你朋友耍，跟朋友去打篮球、吃饭、火锅那些，中学就开始这种就。必须要下课以后都是讲四川话，所以我从小就是跟朋友在外面都是讲四川话，但是上课的时候必须要讲标准的普通话，但是下课就可以随便说。对，
Wow！
我两个哥哥也是在成都长大的，他们的四川话特别溜。
我听懂了一点，但是你可以给我们证明你是美国人吗？
什么？
你可以给我们证明你是美国人吗
可以啊，
？Like
就。因为
cause you speaking Sichuan Hua like that is like I barely even believe that you're American。
，yeah，我给你看一个护照，
不是，就
对，
可以讲一会儿英文吗？
可以，yeah，so，yeah，the main，yeah，I'll kind of introduce myself. My name is Jonathan. I grew up because my parents kind of had a unique work experience working in China as professors. So I grew up for 15 years in China in not just, the whole country of China, but specifically the Southwest region, so the Sichuan region, which is very culturally diverse than the rest of the kind of eastern parts of China. So it's Southwest, so there's a lot of minority groups there, and one of the traditional things in the Sichuan province, so kind of provinces are like states in America. In this province, we have a specific vernacular and we have a dialect. I wouldn't go as far to say it's a whole nother language, but it's a dialect of Mandarin. So it shares, of course, the same language family coming from Mandarin, but it's quite different in the way the pronunciation is the most obvious thing. But then there's a lot of even vocabulary changes, ways you end or start sentences can be different.
Hello, everybody. Just real quick before we get back to the video, wanted to give a real quick shout out to our amazing sponsor, Babbel. It's this app that I really like for learning languages. I've been using it to learn Italian recently, and I really, really like it. It's basically kind of like a better and slightly more serious version of Duolingo. Unfortunately, they don't have Chinese, but they do have a ton of other languages. Essentially, it's just perfect if you have like, 15 to like 60 minutes per day. So I really like using it in the morning, with a little bit of coffee, going over the Babbel, going over the routines. And it's really great because it kind of walks you through these like dialogues and like real life situations, and it kind of gives you a lot of like really actual nice material for how to learn to have a conversation with a native speaker. So it's just a really great app. And yeah, if you're interested in learning any one of the gajillion languages they have to offer, definitely be sure to go check them out at my affiliate link, bit.ly.com/XiaomanyC, and you get 50% off for the first 6 months. And I know you're gonna like it because it's a great app and I love it too. Back to the video, guys. Let's go.
So what I was saying in Sichuan is at school, all the teachers are kind of required to teach you Mandarin, or they teach in Putonghua, which is standard form of Mandarin. But then in Chengdu, outside of class, you're spending your whole time with your friends. I grew up playing basketball. That was kind of my big thing growing up in China. How I really connected with the culture and met friends was through basketball. And you know, you're only speaking Chengdu or Sichuanhua, the Sichuanese dialect, outside of class. Wow. So for me, as a foreigner growing up in China, speaking Sichuanese or that Sichuan dialect is part of my identity. As when I say I'm from Chengdu, when somebody asks me,
right?
Because when I go down to the street or in the community that I lived in, you know, obviously a lot of people knew my family just because we were one of the few foreign families. But when I walk into a restaurant in a side of town that I don't know, and I initiate with Sichuanhua, there I don't get the same questions of like, oh my gosh, he's a foreigner that speaks Chinese, or like, I don't kind of get those like, I do get some kind of like wide eyes, but because I am fortunate enough and blessed to like learn that dialect, when I speak that dialect, I'm not seen as a foreigner in Chengdu, at least.
Right.
Because there's not a lot of foreigners that speak this dialect, because it's, you know, you would never move to China and learn this specific dialect. So it's very unique to my story, and speaking that dialect has opened a lot of doors and given me kind of a home there. Of, you know, when I go and eat dinner at a restaurant that I don't know, they immediately see me as a white person, as a foreigner. But when I engage with them in their local language, they kind of immediately have this accepting thing of, oh, if you speak Sichuanese, you must have lived in China for a very long, you must have lived in Chengdu for a very long time. So thus it's kind of like we're Xiongdi, we're kind of like brother and sister being from the same city. It's kind of like, you're kind of part of the family a little bit. So I'd say, yeah, that's a little bit about me. After graduating from high school, I moved to the US to study biology and kind of wanted to focus on the STEM areas. And now I'm actually in a master's program studying business management and marketing. So, and with hopes to return to China someday and, you know, work in marketing or work, you know, work with some of the great companies that are there.
Wow. 所以你是真的觉得你家乡是成都吧?
对,我 从3岁到18岁, 所以你问我你老家是哪儿, 我肯定会说成都。 因为从3岁到18岁, 这些年 就是很重要的, in terms of your development, very important years.
Yeah.
心里面就四川就是老家。
很酷的。
谢谢。
那你回到美国是什么样的感觉?
我刚回到美国, 我18岁的时候, 去上大学的时候, 我觉得有点困难, 因为 从小在中国长大，然后你搬到美国，你我一看你在大学的时候，有新的学生看我，他觉得哎，他肯定就是美国了。我跟他们说，哎，我也是美国人，但是我从小在中国长大，有一点他们能听懂这个你老家是另外的国家，但是有一点就是那种文化，就美国文化，我有点最开始的时候没有适应到。 美国的文化，你刚来的时候有没有一些culture shock之类的事情发生？对啊，在你身上，我觉得有，特别就是吃饭的时候，在美国他们经常在那个cafeteria，在那个餐馆，美国的餐馆。我到美国，我吃美国这边做的米饭，觉得很硬，
对，
最简单的米饭没有做好，所以我常常就在我自己的房间里面做一些方便面，那个我最喜欢的就是那个康师傅。 红烧牛肉面，对，我回到中国的时候，你就是个中国人，有2个星期的放假的时间，我回到中国，然后我就从美国带了一个行李，什么东西都没有装，然后我回到美国的时候，从四川我就带那个心里面就放了很多吃的，下一个学期我就吃的就没有什么问题，因为我自己带过来了。哇，
你跟你的兄弟们在一起的时候讲四川话，讲这个成都话，经常，对。
我父母也会讲普通话，我爸妈都普通话很好，但是他们的你们一家白人都之间都讲成成成四川话，就是特别就是我跟我哥哥在外面的话，我们想悄悄的说什么在外面，我们可以讲四川话，然后有一些美国的白人或者美就美国的人就会看一看就觉得有点奇怪，因为那个声音不像西班牙语，有些人就会看有点怪怪的。
They made the decision to send you to local schools, I guess. Which
yeah, so that was actually a decision that my parents did that was very different than
very different.
A lot of the other families.
Because a lot of foreigners growing up in China, they will send their kids to like international schools where you grow up not speaking any Chinese, you just it's just like an English or French, whatever bubble.
But you went to the local schools.
They made the decision basically after kind of seeing other families have the same situation of like, oh, I've sent my kid to international school and they don't really speak. You know, there was a French international school in Chengdu that they taught the kids French as the second language. So, which I think is, you know, not great. But my parents, and there was one other family that kind of did the same thing of like, you know, we were the only foreign kids who have ever gone to this school. We all kind of went to the same school. And we kind of like followed each other in which middle school we transferred to and which like high school we started out. I switched to the international school starting my sophomore year of high school just because the opportunities to play sports and like basketball and soccer become less and less in Chinese high schools, unfortunately, because of the Gaokao, everyone's studying. So I wanted to switch to the international school to be able to play sports. And the international school I went to was really, really great and academically and both like I was able to travel to like Qingdao and Shenyang for like sports tournaments and stuff. So I definitely super value the opportunity to go to Chinese public school, but ending at international school for me was still a good switch.
And what did it feel like going to school with all the other kids were Chinese and speaking Chinese?
Yeah, my first and second grade, I kind of remember the first week not being like bullied or anything, but just really seen as the outsider. Like in first grade, I was the only white kid, only foreigner in the whole school, except for my brother who was like a few years above.
Yeah.
So like they knew that I had like a brother at the same school, but it was actually within the first week we were playing this, we were kids and we were playing this like cap game where you have like a bottle cap and you try to hit the other person's off the table. And I distinctly remember one of my still good friends from China, like I still keep up with him, like childhood friend of like, he invited me over to play this game with the other kids. And I was just like, in second grade, I started playing basketball and stuff and was part of the club. And I think especially with basketball, you know, we can come to the court and be from two different countries, speak two different languages, look completely different. But when you're playing something like basketball, it doesn't matter. It matters if you're a good teammate.
Yeah.
It matters if you pass the ball, if you communicate. So I kind of used sports as my way of making friends. And I found that like within a month of going to school, all the teachers like, oh, this kid's just a kid. He has blonde hair. You know, I used to have really blonde hair. I used to stick out, you know, but, you know, he's just, you know, he plays basketball with Wang Ming and the other kids. So like, he's just another, you know, when you're 7 years old, you're 7 years old, no matter what you look like, and you're interested in the same things generally. So I found my experience in Chinese public school to be very, very rewarding and not something traumatic or something where I was like the only isolated foreigner, but definitely built community with the other kids through sports.
Wow. And did your parents have any reason to sit, like, why do they want to give you?
Yeah, my parents will still to this day say, my mom especially should say, I had kind of like two goals of where my kids living in China. I want them to love and understand the culture and like love and understand the people. And in order to do that, you have to speak the language. So. Right.
I think that's so cool what they did because, you know, clearly like it was just like this amazing gift that you were given essentially.
Definitely. It's such a blessing. And I think, especially now with, you know, growing up, it wasn't so much the case, but, you know, in the last 5, 10 years, you know, U.S.-China relations from a political standpoint and from a cultural standpoint have become so at the front lines of the headlines are. So I think being somebody who's kind of been in the middle of both cultures, I think, not that I feel like I have this obligation, but I think I definitely want to use my language ability in order to better, you know, help. I don't want to go into international relations or anything like that, but just kind of in a day-to-day basis, help bridge these kind of cultural differences. And then on a kind of like bigger life goals of like, you know, one day maybe being able to help some of these relations become better or, you know.
Yeah.
So I definitely it's such a blessing to speak Mandarin and, you know, not just put it on your resume, but kind of live it out. And
yeah. After COVID, you can come up here to New York. We'll go to some Sichuan restaurants and
I would love people. That. That'd be super fun to, some trends high, yeah.
Well, speaking of surprising people with your Sichuanese, though, I have a couple of Sichuanese friends who they don't know anything about your story. I want to invite them to this group, and you can practice Sichuanese with them.
Yeah. So you said you lived in the Chinatown area?
Chinatown. Yeah, Chinatown, exactly.
I need to come. I've never been to New York or China. I've been to Chicago's Chinatown, which was cool.
Chicago doesn't have a Chinatown. Chicago's Chinatown is like a tiny little street.
Really? Okay,
Yeah.
I didn't know. I've never been to any of the big Chinatowns, so.
Hey, Jerry, ni hao.
你好，你好。
我这边是一个美国朋友，他最近在练习他的四川话，然后我特别邀请你们四川人来。
来嘛。
你是在四川哪个地方长大的？
我是成都人。
我也是成都人。哪个区
哎，
呢？
可惜，你在成都待了好久嘞？
我从3岁到18岁，所以待了16年，差不多。
哦，不错，厉害。
哎，Yanni，你好。
你好，小马。
我们今天在学四川话。
好呀。
对，我的朋友这边会讲一点，他是美国人。
会讲一点点，对。
他会讲
讲
真
得
正
真
的四
好。
川话吗？
你也是从小在四川长大的哇？
你说的比我还说得好哦。我说乐山话说的比较好，但是两个都说的不好。